Okay, you're back in high school, and your history teacher says, you can't use your notes on the upcoming final. But you may write whatever you want on a 3x5-inch index card and use that on the test. So the question becomes, how do you fit as much information as possible on your note card? Well, you start by trying the most basic strategy. You try writing your notes as small as you reasonably can on your index card and filling up all the empty space. This technique is okay. You're able to fit about 2,190 characters on each side of your note card with this method, which will do if you're taking maybe a unit test, but not a final. So what else can you do? What if you wrote your notes in Chinese characters? Seriously, the Chinese writing system is more information dense than English. Information density just tells you how much information can be fit in a small space. Chinese's information density is higher than the English writing system, which is what we want. Okay, so you'll just take the time you could be using to study for your test to learn Mandarin. No problem. Except there is a problem. There are thousands of Chinese characters to memorize. That's why it's so information dense compared to the Latin alphabet, which has just 26 symbols. So learning it is going to take you a lot longer than you thought. The final is just in a few weeks. You don't have time for that. So what are your other options? Okay, so you stick with English, but this time you print out your notes instead of writing them. But exactly how small can your printer print? Well, if you use a word editor like Microsoft Word, the answer is clear. Around 6 points. That's the limit. If you want to go any smaller, you'll have to find another way. So instead of using Microsoft Word, you use Microsoft Paint, or whatever image editor you have available. Now, you can make your text even smaller than 6 pixels tall. But the problem is, that's too small to be readable, which is what Microsoft Word is trying to prevent. So you have to change the font to one that's readable at a very low resolution. At first, you consider Comic Sans, because even though it is ugly, it was originally designed with the purpose of being easily readable at a low resolution during the low-res era of Microsoft Bob. But even Comic Sans isn't readable at 5 pixels tall. Enter Tiny Font, literally designed to be really small. Its largest character, the pound symbol, is just 5 pixels wide by 5 pixels tall, 25 pixels total. But how many pixels can you fit on your index card? Well, printers work with dots, not pixels, and most printers can print at least 300 dots per inch. That's 90,000 dots on just 1 square inch of paper. Your index card is 15 square inches, so it should be able to fit 1,350,000 dots. So, if you have a 1-to-1 ratio of dots to pixels, your index card should be able to fit at least 54,000 characters. 54,000, that's enough for the first 25 pages of this book, The Color of Magic. But you still haven't actually tested if it works yet. Nope. The letters are a blurry mess, even under a magnifying glass. It could be because the paper is too coarse and uneven, so the ink gets all blotchy, but whatever the reason, it's completely unreadable. The text actually has to be this big in order to be readable. So you're able to fit about 13,000 characters on your index card with this method. Pretty disappointing considering your original estimate, but still, it's progress. Anyway, from here on out, if you want to fit more characters than this, you'll have to step up your game. So you decide that your notes don't have to be easy to read, just possible to read. This is where codes come in. So computers translate text information into binary information using a system called Unicode. If you're living in 2018, it's called ASCII if you're living under a rock. But you can create your own system of translating 6-digit binary numbers into English characters. You'll print the binary numbers on your index card, But instead of printing them out as zeros and ones, you'll print them out as white pixels and black pixels. That way, each character will only be 6 pixels big, smaller than the 25 pixel characters in tiny font. Why does the binary number have to be 6 digits long specifically? Well, I challenge you to figure that out. Your clue is that you need to represent 37 different characters with your binary system, the 26 letters of the alphabet, the 10 digits, and also a space. Unicode, on the other hand, handles thousands of characters, even ridiculous-looking ones like this. Because Unicode has to handle so many characters, those characters are often represented with a binary number 16 digits long. Anyway, all that's left to do now is to painstakingly paint your image one pixel at a time in the pixel editor with your unique binary code. Every 6 pixels is the start of a new binary number, and therefore a new character of your encoded message. And what's the result? Well, you run into a problem. These pixels are too small to be clearly readable. You'll have to make each pixel bigger on the page. So instead of fitting this many pixels, now you're only able to fit this many. Oh well. You're still able to fit a total of about 11,452 characters on your index card. Wait, 11,000? Weren't we able to fit 13,000 with tiny font? Did we really just take a step backwards? Okay, you can do this. What if you simply assign each of your 37 characters a unique color? Each character is represented with just one pixel, and the color of that pixel tells you what character it is. That means that since your index card can fit 68,000 pixels, it should be able to fit 68,000 characters. I mean, color is already used in the real world to send messages. Take maritime signal flags, for example. They're sometimes used by ships to communicate. But many of these flags are just the same shape colored differently. That way, you don't have to have a unique shape for every flag. The point is, the flag system uses color to its advantage. As a side note, this 37-color method should be particularly easy for you if you have synesthesia. If you have graphene color synesthesia, you associate each letter of the alphabet with a color. For example, E might be green to you, and O might be blue to you. That's just the way it looks when you see it on the page. I have synesthesia, and if you'd like to see what written text looks like to me, then there's a link in the description to an online simulation I created. Anyway, without further ado, let's test the 37-color method. Well, this is unreadable. There are just too many unique colors. It's not that the pixels are too small, but for example, we can't really tell which ones are orange and which ones are a slightly different shade of orange. Maybe a computer could figure this out, but not a human. So we'll have to try again, but this time with colors that are easier to discern. So here's what you want to do in order to make this work. This time, you use only the primary colors. If you were using paint, those colors would be red, yellow, and blue. If you were using light, those colors would be red, green, and blue. But since you're using printer ink, those colors are yellow, cyan, magenta, and black. Hence, YMCK. This way, the printout should be easier to read because the printer won't be trying to mix multiple primary colors together. It only has to worry about colors that are already inside the printer. However, that creates a new problem. How do you use just 4 colors to represent 37 unique characters? Simple. Instead of using just one color to represent a character, you'll use color groups. For example, cyan, yellow, black will represent the letter F, and black, black, magenta will represent the letter W, etc., etc. Every 3 pixels will be the start of a new character. I mean, if you think about it, this is really just the same as the binary system, but instead of limiting ourselves to black and white, we're going with 4 colors rather than 2. Once again, I challenge you to figure out why you can use no less than 3 colors to represent each of our 37 characters. Well, you'll be darned. It works! You can now fit 22,905 characters on your index card, exactly twice as many as the binary method, since this time we're using 3 pixels per character instead of 6. This is actually readable. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd say we have a winner! Or do we? That's right, you've still got 1 trick left up your sleeve, and all you need to pull it off is a pair of 3D glasses. So when I got to this point in the project, I was feeling pretty confident that nothing could beat the YMCK method. But when I told my sister about the whole thing, she blew me away with this idea. Write the first half of your notes in red. Next, write the second half of your notes in blue, but overlapping the red half. Then, look at your notes through a pair of 3D glasses, and you'll only be able to see 1 set of notes through each lens. So I tried it. But before I share with you the result, why do 3D glasses have those dumb-looking colored lenses in the first place? Seriously, 30 years from now, kids will be asking us what on earth these ridiculous-looking glasses were for. Well, 3D movies achieve the 3D effect by displaying a slightly different image to each of your eyes. The red lens on your glasses filters out the red image, allowing you only to see the blue image. And the blue lens does the reverse on your other eye. So each of your eyes sees a different image, and your brain puts both images together in your mind to create that 3D effect. That's what makes a 3D movie different from a 2D movie. A 3D movie shows a different image to each of your eyes, whereas a 2D movie shows the same image to both eyes. So, if you want your 3D movie to become a 2D movie, all you have to do is watch it through just 1 lens. Of course, they don't use the colored lenses in cinemas anymore. Now they use polarized lenses, which look slightly less ridiculous, but they essentially work the same way. We want the colored 3D glasses, also called anaglyph 3D glasses, and you'll see why. So, you'll actually have to go out and find a pair.
You gotta be kidding me.
Finally! Now, back to the image editor. You use tiny font just like before, but this time, overlap 2 text boxes, and you color 1 text box cyan, and the other one red. You look through each lens, and the blue text looks fine, but the red text, what's going on? Simple. The blue text is covering up the red text because it's 1 layer higher. If you put the red text on top, then you have the opposite problem. But this problem has a solution. See, pixels that are overlapping are shared by both texts. So you want shared pixels to be visible through both lenses. The color black is pretty easy to see through both lenses, so you color shared pixels black, which looks like this. Notice how each black pixel is part of both the red text and the blue text. So, once again, you try the 3D glasses and success! That's right, we're now able to fit twice as many characters on our index card as we did with regular Tiny Font, which moves us from 13,000 characters to 26,000. Even better than YMCK. Oh, and did I mention you can use the front side and the back side? So all of our numbers get doubled. That's 52,000 characters, 1/6 of the color of magic, 1/6 of an entire novel on an index card. Thank you, thank you. I'd like to thank my parents, my colleagues, my dentist, and most importantly, my sister, who outperformed me in 10 minutes at something that took me weeks to figure out. Screw you, sis. But also thank you. By the way, if you really do have an inexplicably large number of notes to fit on your index card for tomorrow's test, then I created a program that automates the red and cyan text coloring for you. You can find it on my website. A link is in the description. Unfortunately, because the software I used has issues with aliasing, I wasn't able to use Tiny Font, so it's only able to fit about 6,500 characters. Aww. Keep in mind, though, that you don't have to put in any work at all. No hand cramps, no binary numbering, no color picking, and no learning Mandarin. You get those 6,000 characters for free. Now that this is finally out of my hair, if you'll excuse me, I'm going to watch Spy Kids 3D. This movie was better when I was 8. Young man!
I'm gonna press play so that you know when to hold up the letters.
That was good.